Hi, welcome to part 2 of the carousel blanket. In part 2 we make all these bands. We join the bands together and also we place part 1 in the middle of the blanket and join all these stitches all the way around. Let's get started. Start with a slip knot on the hook. And we make 11 chain stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Now count 3 stitches back. That's 1, 2 and 3. And in this third chain stitch you make a double crochet yarn over and the hook in that third chain stitch, count from the hook, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. Now we have here 2 double crochets here in the beginning. Into the next 8 stitches work also 1 double crochet, yarn over, enter hook in the next stitch, that's 1, into the next stitch and double crochet, that's 2, in the next stitch, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we have here, including that chain stitch here in the beginning, 10 double crochets in total. Row 2, we turn our work and we start with a chain 2. Counts for a first double crochet. Into the next 8 stitches make 1 double crochet. Yarn over, enter hook into the next stitch. And then under through that V. And make a double crochet. That's the first of 8 in total. That's 1, into the next stitch. 2 in the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and on the top of the last stitch, that's number 8. And now we have to make also here in that chain 2 on the top, 1 double crochet, yarn over, and the hook in the last stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and make a double crochet. Now we have also 10 double crochets including that chain 2. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Row 3, turn your work and then we start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet. Now on the top of the first stitch where you make also the chain 2, go back in that same beginning stitch with another double crochet. So we increase one more stitch. Now you have 2 double crochets in that same first stitch here. Into the next 8 stitches, 1 double crochet, that's 1, into the next stitch, 2, in the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and on the top of the last double crochet, that's number 8. Now we have to make on the top of that chain 2, also 1 double crochet. On the chain 2, also 1 double crochet. Now you have 11 double crochets In total, that's including that chain two here in the beginning. You start on row 4, turn your work and begin with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet. Now in the next 9 stitches, make 1 double crochet. This is the first, there we make that chain 2 on the top, go to the next stitch, that's 1, into the next, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and on the top of the last double crochet, that's number 9, and we have to make here on the top of that chain 2 also 1 double crochet. And we have here 11 double crochets in total, including that chain 2. Row 5, turn and start with a chain 2. Counts for a first double crochet. Now here in the beginning, where we make that chain 2, go back in that same first stitch with a double crochet. Now we increase a stitch. We have here 2 double crochets in that same beginning stitch. And double crochet in the next 9 stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and here on the top of the last double crochet, that's number 9, and then we have to make also a double crochet here on the top of the chain 2. Now we have, including that chain 2 here in the beginning, 12 double crochets in total. Row 6, turn and start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet. Make a double crochet into the next stitch. This is the beginning stitch. On top we make that chain 2, then in the next stitch, 1 double crochet, like this. And we make also 1 double crochet in the next 9 stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and on the top of the last double crochet here, that's number 9, and also a double crochet in the top of the first chain 2 here. Twelve double crochets in total. You start on row 7, turn your work and start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet. Make a double crochet back in that same stitch, here, in that first stitch here on the top. So we have 2 double crochets in that same beginning stitch. Into the next 10 stitches, 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3. It's 9 on the top of the last double crochet. That's number 10. And also here on the chain 2, in the top of the chain 2 here, also 1 double crochet. So we have now, including that chain 2, 13 double crochets. Row 8, we turn and make and chain 2, and then we make in the next stitch 1 double crochet, not that first stitch but in the next stitch, and in the next 10 stitches also 1 double crochet. That's 1, 2, 9 on the top of the last double crochet. That's number 10, and a double crochet also on the top of that chain 2 here in the beginning, including that chain 2, we have now 13 double crochets. You start on row 9, turn your work and start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet. Now we increase a stitch, a double crochet in that same beginning stitch here, where we also make on the top that chain 2. So we have 2 double crochets in that first top of that first double crochet. Now in the next 11 stitches, make 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, number 10 on the top of the last double crochet is number 11, and also a double crochet on that top of that chain 2. Including that chain 2, we have now 14 double crochets. Row 10, turn, start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet, and then make 1 double crochet into the next stitch, and also a double crochet in the next 11 stitches. And then on the top of the chain 2 here, work also 1 double crochet. Then you have on the end of this row, including that chain 2, 14 double crochets. Row 11, turn and start with a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet, and then make a double crochet back in that same first stitch. Now we have 2 double crochets in that first stitch. Into the next 12 stitches also 1 double crochet, and a double crochet on the top of that chain 2, and then you have 15 double crochets in total. Row 12, turn, make a chain 2, counts for a first double crochet, and then a double crochet into the next stitch. Make also 1 double crochet in the next 12 stitches, and on the top of the last chain 2 here also 1 double crochet. 15 double crochets in total, including that chain 2 here in the beginning. Row 13, turn and make that chain 2 in the beginning, counts for a first double crochet. Back in that first stitch here, make one double crochet, so you have two double crochets in that same stitch. Into the next 13 stitches, make one double crochet, and then on the top of that chain two, also one double crochet. Then you have, including that first chain two counts for a double crochet, 16 double crochets in total. You start on row 14, make a chain two, and then you make a double crochet into the next stitch. And also a double crochet into the next 13 stitches. On the top of that last chain two here in the beginning, also one double crochet. Then you have 16 double crochets in total. Row 15, turn and start with that chain 2, back in that same first stitch, one double crochet. So you increase one more stitch, two double crochets in that same stitch, including that chain 2. And double crochet into the next 14 stitches, one double crochet on the top of the last chain 2. That makes 17 double crochets in total. Row 16, and this is the last row, then is this first petal complete. Turn, make a chain two, counts for a first double crochet, and then a double crochet into the next stitch, and also in the next 14 stitches. On the top of that chain two, make also one double crochet. And the first banding is complete. Now cut the yarn and open up that stitch and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. You turn upside down and then on the back of the stitches weave both tails in. I wave the tails in. Now you see that we have here one straight side and one side is a little bit to the outside. And that's what we want. One band is complete. Make seven more bands of the cream color, eight in total, and make eight of these in the lipstick color. So we have eight in cream, eight in lipstick, 16 in total. Now we have 8 of these banding in red and also 8 in the cream color. And then we place 2 colors to each other and make join stitches like this. In the red side we make single crochets and in the cream side we make only slip stitches. We take a red and a cream. And we place the straight side to each other. So we have two here. We go to the outside, but we place the straight side together. And then with a new color on the hook, we start on the banding of the red color hieronder in the first stitch. And we place here a slip stitch into that first stitchje on the bottom to attach the yarn. Make a slip stitch and also a slip stitch here on the other side of the cream color. Here on the bottom, go in and work a slip stitch. Your yarn is under your work, yarn over, and then pull through and pull through. Now we join the first stitches together. The pattern of the join stitches here, that first row around the first double crochet, you go around that stitch, not in that stitch, but around that double crochet, enter your hook and make a single crochet. Scrap your yarn, pull through, yarn over and pull through two. Now we go to the right side of the cream side. You go around that double crochet in that space, around that stitch, yarn over, pull through and pull through to make a slip stitch. Back to the red color, the next row, row 2, go around the next double crochet, over the double crochet, between the two double crochets here, enter your hook, grab your yarn and pull a loop, yarn over and pull through two to make a single crochet. Work the stitches very loosely, not too tight. Go to the cream side on row 2, around the next double crochet and make a slip stitch. Yarn over, pull through, pull through. Row 3 of the right side, around the next double crochet. You see that I enter the hook between the double crochets in that space. Yarn over, pull a loop, make a single crochet. Yarn over, pull through two. To the cream side, round 3, around the next double crochet. You're in that space, around that stitch, make a slip stitch. Yarn over, pull through, pull through. And this is the way how we work all the join stitches all the way up to the top here. Round 4, around the next stitch, make a single crochet. Round 4 on the cream side, enter your hook and make a slip stitch. Round 5, around the stitch, make a single crochet. Round 5, row 5, enter your hook and make a slip stitch. Work like this all the way up to the top. Yeah. The last row, around the last double crochet, a single crochet, also on the other side, you make a slip stitch. And then we have to make one more join stitch. So we close the top here, enter your hook in a stitch here on the top, on the first double crochet, make a slip stitch and also a slip stitch here on the top of the double crochet here, the first double crochet, also one slip stitch. Then make a chain to make a little knot, cut the yarn. And now we have this. Now we grab a needle, turn our work, and I wave the tail in only in the yellow color stitches. Go under through the yellow stitches here. pull through, then the other side, under through the yellow stitches, the mustard stitches, color mustard I have here. Go over the next little thread here and go all the way back under through the stitches like this. And then cut the yarn. Do this also on the other side here. Leave the tails in. Work like this, all the banding together, till you have 8 of these groups. Then place the banding like this together and work all the join stitches at the same way that you did before here. Then place the next group and make all the join stitches. And the next group, make all the join stitches all the way around till you have one big circle. Now we have all the pieces joined together, and then we place part one, the center, in the middle of that carousel. The yarn is back on the hook, and we start with a slip stitch in a chain 2 space here. The hook, make a slip stitch. And we join at the same way. First we make a slip stitch here on the top of that mustard color slip stitches, join stitches. Go in to the top of that stitch, yarn over, and make a slip stitch. Enter hook in the first stitch here after the corner chain 2 space of part 1, the center of the blanket, and make 1 single crochet in that stitch. Now go to this bending here, the first stitch, under through, and make a slip stitch. Go to the next stitch of part 1, make a single crochet, back to the bending, here on the top of the next stitch, and make a slip stitch. Single crochet into the next stitch of part 1 and in the next stitch. Here you make 1 slip stitch. All the way to that cream color and the red color, and then make here in the next chain 2 space a slip stitch, and also a slip stitch here in the mustard color join stitches. This is the way how you work all the way around. Then here in the beginning, cut the yarn and weave on the back of your blanket the stitches in. I'm all the way around and make my last slip stitch here. Now I cut the yarn, open that stitch, then with the needle you pull that thread to the first slip stitch here in the middle. Yeah, on the top, pull it through to the back side of your blanket, and now weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. I weave the tails in on the back of the blanket, and we're done with part 2. I hope to see you in part 3. Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!